this is the most commonly asked question in my channel. How do I get a client project? Where do I find a client project? And yeah, I've been saying you need to do networking for many times, but I guess it's not an answer that satisfies most of you guys, so I'm trying to fill in the gap here, okay? I don't suggest you to go out there and directly apply to jobs that already exist on the internet because they have high competition, and it's unlikely if you don't have real-world project at hand to get those jobs. Instead, I suggest you to do the following. The first thing you need to do is use your unfair advantage. Unfair advantage means the thing that you have access to but other people don't have access to. Some example includes if you're in a school, your school may have some special internship programs, or your school may have like job fairs that only open up to your school's student, including you. But the thing about unfair advantage is that it's very likely for ourselves to ignore our unfair advantage because we've been living it all life long. For example, if you are living in a tech hub like Bangalore, India, Lagos, Nigeria, Bay Area, Silicon Valley, just go to those networking events. It's literally right next door. And my personal example of using unfair advantage is that when I was in university, our school had this special program collaboration with a firm in Tokyo. So it was pretty easy for me to apply for a design internship position at a Tokyo startup. And then I flew to Tokyo in the summer and I lived in the Shibuya area for 2 months. They even gave me a house for free to live with my classmates. It was a dream life. It's definitely an unfair advantage that got me to that position. So make sure to find yours. Another thing you shall do is in-person networking event. Especially if you're living in a tech hub, Bangalore, India, Lagos, Nigeria, Silicon Valley. Go to as many events as possible. You can find it on Eventbrite or Meetup or any local event kind of website. You shall expand your network not just to other product designers or UX designers. You shall also expand your network just to people in general who's in the tech industry or potential client that you feel like you can improve their product. And I will share you my networking secret. If you want anybody's LinkedIn or Gmail, if they're not a speaker at the event, have a genuine conversation with them and then be like, is it okay if we take a photo together? I want to capture this event. And then tell them, do you want the photo? Give me your email, I can send it to you. You get that person's email. If this person is a speaker at the event, just go to the front, take some nice photo of this person. And whenever this person is done speaking, go up there, ask some questions, and also tell them, hey, I took some photo of you when you were speaking. Would you like me to send the photo to you? And they will say, yes, of course. And then you can ask, what is your LinkedIn? What's your Gmail? Here, you get another person's Gmail or LinkedIn, and this time from a speaker. I figured this out myself, and it has been my networking secret since 18 years old. I talked about it here when I was still a very young YouTuber. And when you're doing networking, the thing that gets you to become a person's connection, of course, to some extent, is your job, is your career. But the thing that sticks people together is just the most people-ish stuff. Let me tell you an example. When I was 18 years old, I volunteered as a photographer to this most expensive Silicon Valley event for CEOs around the world. And that's why I was at this dinner table, and sitting right in front of me is the CEO of a very famous German car company. I was an 18 years old kid, okay? I don't know what I can say because I feel like hierarchy-wise, I'm so much lower than them. But then people start to ask me, where are you from? And this question can spark so much conversation. I just told them I'm from Beijing, China. And then they start to say, oh, I've worked with clients in Beijing, China. I've worked with people in China. You guys use WeChat, right? And the funniest thing, for the next 15 minutes, I start to show people how does the WeChat interface looks like compared to WhatsApp. And we just start to have the most human conversation ever. It's not all related to tech, but it just really connects us together. So even if you're an aspiring designer, even if you don't have a lot of industry knowledge, it's still totally okay for you to connect with anyone you like in a networking event. I will tell you 2 more secrets. But before that, I need to let you know that I'm developing a course called Fast Track to UX, a 4-week Figma crash course. This course is designed to polish up your personal portfolio project so that you can land a real-world project. It basically fills in the gap of Google certificates or other traditional UX bootcamps out there. Because I went through taking courses myself, doing personal project, do a real-world client project, and then getting my job in eBay, and now starting up my own company. And this journey, it's long, but I've made so many mistakes in between, and I know what exactly you need to know to get to the next step, and that is why I'm doing this course. So if you want a discount when the course goes live, check out the link in the description. There's a form. You fill in that form, I will give you a discount. Now to the next part. The next secret of getting a real-world client is changing your perspective from I need a job to you need a design service. These are two completely different things. You need a job are self-centric. You are thinking about your problem. But hey, you want to become a product designer. But a product designer solves problems for other people. I will share you my example again. Oh my God, how many years ago? I don't even remember. But basically, at this networking event, I met this speaker. He's this innovation guy in the Silicon Valley. He provides innovation services to a lot of companies. And he mentors and teaches chief innovation officer, I think that's how he calls. And he has the most unbelievable, eye-catching, catchy speech I have ever heard. It's like a TED Talk, but 1 hour long TED Talk. But for the entire hour, you want to listen to this guy. But something I realized is that he can totally get some help from polishing up the look of his deck. I basically first talked to him and then I gave him his photos because I had my camera. So I got his contact. And during the summer break of my university program, I emailed him and said that, hey, I remember you had this amazing speech. You offer these amazing services to all other companies. I think your services can be benefited from a more polished deck design. During summer, I would like to work with you as an intern to help you to polish up those slides. And in addition, I can also do product design if you have any product in mind, UI design if you want to design a website. And then he immediately said yes. So the thing I did here is that instead of say, hey, I really need a job, can you help me? Say, hey, I can help you because you need a design service. And now I'm going to share you the final secret. This one is kind of level up, you know, it's kind of like the higher level of networking. But I believe eventually you'll get here. This level is not about seeking opportunities yourself. This level is about attracting opportunities. Basically, you do personal branding and you no longer send any other person emails or job applications. You just keep doing personal branding and then brands will come to you. This, of course, will take time, but I believe the basic of this shall be done for absolutely everyone, which include you need a professional headshot, or at least like a clear headshot on your LinkedIn profile. You need a good LinkedIn profile so that whenever people search you on LinkedIn, all the past experiences, they're well written. If you don't know how to write them, ChatGPT knows how to write them. Tell ChatGPT what you've done, and then it will write you a really good point forms. And then use your own language, your own tone to write down those point forms. And I started to do personal branding when I was at my worst. If you look at my YouTube channel, you can see that the most viewed video from my YouTube channel is this Google UX certificate review video that I've done when basically my entire self-esteem is eaten by the job rejection letters I've got. I just graduated with no job, no money, no status in the United States, and I'm taking this course because I want to level up my UX design and I need a job, and I did this review program, and then it blew up. It's not like I do one video, it blew up. I did hundreds of videos before that. I archived all of them because they're so embarrassing. But anyways, that video blew up and I don't need to search for jobs anymore because people will come to me and be like, hey, do you want to do this project with me? Yeah, this will take time and there's no formula to it. But I believe if you try everything I've said today, you will figure out what you are good at. And whenever you figure out what you are good at, double down on that. You will find your first real world client. And just as I said for many of my other videos, I believe the skills you've learned in UI UX design and product design can be applied to so many more things beyond UI UX design. If you want to start a business, you've learned how to design a product all by yourself. If you want to just apply to your life, make your day better? Well, just think about you are your client now. How to make your user experience better as someone who's living in your apartment, as someone who's living in your current situation, how to design a better day for yourself, right? So I believe you can get there and you can always apply your UIUX still on a daily basis. And of course, my course can help you a lot on that as well. So if you want a discount on my upcoming course, check out the description below and fill in the form. You will not regret it. You don't have to buy it if you don't like the curriculum, you know? At least get a discount code and you can send it to some of your friends who want to buy it. That is enough sales and that is enough giveaway for today. If you want more, comment down below. Also, I'm invited to fix my config next week, so I'm very excited. I'm flying to San Francisco, I will make a vlog. I'll probably also post an Instagram story to ask you guys about what you want to ask to all those crazy cool designers. Yeah, my Instagram is thealianacai. Make sure to follow me so you don't miss that out. And I'm also invited to visit Figma headquarters. So I'm super excited. That's it for today's video. Cheers.